Hi, I'm Brad Healy with Emerson Process Management. We are here to discuss the general features and setup of the Fisher Easy Drive electric actuator mounted on a Fisher D3 or D4 globe valve. Today we're going to dive into the Fisher Easy Drive electric actuator. The Easy Drive was invented to transform onshore oil and gas production control valves and to become more environmentally friendly. Using our patented low power design, the Easy Drive allows customers to power the valve using 12 or 24 volts DC. And while the valve is at rest, it will consume less than 1 watt of power. Unlike other well field designs, the Easy Drive electric actuator is highly responsive and can start from fully open to fully closed in under 6 seconds. Easy Drive is capable of reaching all rated shutoff capabilities for the Fisher field proven D3 and D4 valve models. Using the D3 and D4 valve designs also provides an easily retrofittable option to replace your existing pneumatic equipment. As you can see, on the inside of the actuator casing, there is little exposed wiring and all the moving parts are enclosed within the gearbox. For demonstration purposes, we have cut away part of the gearbox on the D4 assembly. Here you can see that the interior of the gearbox is clutter-free and rather simple. For demonstration purposes, part of this gearbox has been cut away. Units leaving the factory will not have these cutaway sections. As seen on the D3 assembly, each gearbox is sealed and contained. This intuitively designed interior and gearbox assembly allows for quick installation, setup, and calibration. We are now going to set up and calibrate the Easy Drive. After discussing positioning and on-off calibrations, you will be able to install and commission your Easy Drive into a wide array of applications. For safety awareness, as we move forward, please follow the safety precautions located within the instruction manual or follow the protocol at your site. Before we get started, we'd advise that you have a computer that is capable of communicating Modbus RS-485 protocol. We will be using the Easy Drive configuration software to calibrate and configure important variables. For general field installations, this is not necessary, but does allow you to program the actuator and valve settings that work best with your application. On the table, we have the D3 and D4 valves with the Easy Drive actuator. We will now connect the wiring to the terminals within the Easy Drive on the D4 assembly. For safety purposes, make sure that none of your wires are live during this procedure. Some other wiring practice to follow include:
observe local wiring requirements for hazardous location usage. Conduit seals within 450 millimeters or 18 inches of the enclosure port are required for explosion-proof installation. 22 to 12 gauge wire size is required. For long wiring runs, using lower gauge wire is advised. For power, any wire over 50 feet should be 12 gauge. The actuator will demand no more than 4 amps. Therefore, fuse the system to 5 amps. Using shielded wire for both power and signal, connect power and analog signal shields back at the signal source.
During initial setup, ensure a stable DC power source is available and sufficiently surge protected for the application. A 4 amp minimum power supply is required. Use of a 36-volt transient voltage suppressor is also highly recommended. When wiring an on-off unit, the power wiring should be connected to the appropriate terminals. Again, note that power is polarity sensitive and therefore make sure the power cabling has been properly installed and grounded before attempting to power the actuator. When operating the valve in the single dry contact mode, the Easy Drive should be connected to the two switch wires at the common and normally open terminals, terminals 1 and 2 respectively. If operating the valve in the L2E dual contact mode, the Easy Drive should be wired at the common with the brown wire, normally open with the red wire, and normally closed with the blue wire, terminals 1, 2, and 3 respectively. The valve leaves the factory calibrated and ready to be installed in line. However, if recalibration or an adjustment in factory settings is necessary, you will need to connect the valve via Modbus. If you are looking to further configure and calibrate the valve via Modbus, the Fisher Easy Drive configuration software is a user-friendly graphical user interface.
Using a PC with Modbus communication capabilities loaded with the EasyDrive configuration software will allow you to easily access and change Modbus registers to meet calibration and configuration needs.
The EasyDrive configuration software can be found by going to www.fisher.com/EasyDrive. On the EasyDrive webpage, click on User Tools to find the free download.
For demonstration purposes, part of this gearbox has been cut away. Units leaving the factory will not have these cutaway sections. As seen on the D3 assembly, each gearbox is sealed and contained.
As you can see, we have connected our laptop to the actuator via USB to Modbus adapter. The driver for the Modbus output from your PC should be installed before attempting to communicate with the actuator via Modbus. The EasyDrive configuration software has already been installed on this computer. Make sure that Modbus cables leaving your computer are securely fastened to the Modbus terminals on the circuit board. If power is being supplied to the board, then the EasyDrive configuration software will automatically connect to the EasyDrive upon startup. In the event that the configuration software has been pulled up and much of the screen is grayed out, then you will need to first go to Serial Port Settings in the menu bar of the program. Once there, use the scroll down menu to look for the communication device. If it is not present, then go to Device Manager within the PC to make sure that the device has been properly connected and the driver has been successfully installed. Once that has been completed, use the correct baud rate for your device. Ours is 9600 and at an even parity. If the EasyDrive is not connected, then go to EasyDrive Selection within the menu bar and search for the EasyDrive. If the EasyDrive is not found, please contact your local Emerson sales office. Now that you are connected to the EasyDrive, you should see the application has been populated. Again, this configuration software is a graphical user interface that intuitively publishes the Modbus registers. You can change variables such as fail position, low travel cutoff, and the percent dead band you'd like to give the actuator. Also note that Modbus registers can be configured using any Modbus master, such as a flow computer, a PLC, or another PC. All the Modbus registers are outlined in detail within the instruction manual that comes with the valve, or they are published online. We will now be discussing calibrating an on-off unit using digital inputs and the EasyDrive configuration software.
Initiating calibration procedures will cause your valve to move. If the valve is installed in line, be careful this does not cause an accident or an upset in your process.
No real calibration is necessary when using the EasyDrive and on-off modes. The valve has been configured to the L2E dual dry contact mode at the factory. However, it is beneficial to configure the valve to the correct on-off mode depending on your application.
For the first on-off mode, single dry contact achieves continuity across terminals 1, the common, and 2, the normally open. When these are in continuity, or the voltage differential between these terminals is 0, the valve should respond by opening. Once the connection between the common and normally open has been broken, the valve should move to the closed position. Using these wires, we are demonstrating a contact closure.
The second type of on-off mode is the L2E dual dry contact mode. This uses the common, normally open, and normally closed terminals, which are terminals 1, 2, and 3, respectively. We will use the Fisher L2E electric level controller to demonstrate this connection. Notice when the controller is not activated, terminals 1 and 3 are in continuity and the valve is closed. For this example, we will trigger the EasyDrive by activating the L2E. Once the L2E has been activated, continuity is made across terminals 1 and 2, and the valve begins to open. Once the displacer is no longer activated, continuity returns to terminals 1 and 3, and the valve will close. Anytime the EasyDrive is in the on-off mode, it will be configured to either the single dry contact mode or the L2E dry contact mode. This can be achieved by changing certain Modbus registers that are published in the instruction manual, but most easily done with the help of the EasyDrive configuration software. Within the settings box, make sure that the control source is set to local. Once local is selected,
the choice of either single dry contact or L2E dual contact is presented. Select the option that best applies to your application and then click Update.
Once the correct on-off mode has been selected and you click Update, the Easy Drive is now ready to be commissioned in the field. For more information on the Fisher Easy Drive Electric Actuator, go to fisher.com/easydrive or contact your local Emerson sales office.